All right, so we're going to talk about a few different types of millet here. Millet is another warm season grass grain or forage type. This right here is proso millet. This is one of the more common types to grow in the central Great Plains around here. It is an exceptionally drought tolerant. Also, a lot of our warm season grasses are known to use water quite efficiently. In the grand scheme of comparisons, our sorghums tend to be more efficient than our corns. And proso millet here is one of our most efficient in that it grows shorter stature, so it doesn't demand as much water to go to grain, and it can germinate with very little moisture in the soil. So it is a grain, a warm season grain that has a very loose, what we call flower head or panicle, somewhat drooping, similar to actually to a rice type plant in terms of its the type of seed head it has. It forms very small round seeds, and the main market for these currently, at least here in this part of the world in the US, is for bird seed. So while it is a very drought adaptive crop, we can actually grow without irrigation here. The market for bird seeds is not a very high value market, and it's a very volatile market. And so if we had better human food consumption markets for this grain, it would be easier for farmers to grow more of it. And so this is also one we can eat. And so you'll find it often in multi-grain type foods or cereals. But for most part, it's a minor crop in our region, largely due to the market availability. So moving on down here, this is pearl millet. This is one of the most common grains after, so I think it's about the fifth most common grain globally, is our pearl millet. And it can be used for grain, for human consumption, as well as forage types. So you'll see some here that are more vegetative and some that are more focused on seed production. And this is commonly grown and used in southern India, as well as in Africa. And there are efforts underway to adapt it to more of a US Central Plains climate, again, for its heat and drought tolerance in our region. It can be used as a grain just like rice in a lot of ways, as well as integrated into processed foods, and again, as a livestock feed source as well.